Hi everyone, I'm Amrita and welcome to my channel Fries and Shine. Here you will find evidence-based, no-nonsense, nutrition-related information. And in today's video, I'm going to talk about diet for PCOS. In today's video, I will discuss how to optimize the quality of your diet and the quantity of food to help you best manage your PCOS symptoms. I will also touch upon nutrients of concern and what foods you can pick to maximize these. But firstly, what does your diet have to do with PCOS at all? If you remember from my previous video, some girls with PCOS can experience insulin resistance, and with or without insulin resistance, chronic low-grade inflammation is pretty much present in everyone who has PCOS. Now, whether or not the insulin resistance causes any weight gain or fat gain, it can cause other metabolic effects such as variations and increases in cholesterol levels, which is why it's really important that you make the dietary changes needed to manage this. And since carbohydrates have a very direct impact on your insulin levels, what you eat and how much you eat is something that you can absolutely control to help manage your PCOS. So in this video, I'm going to show you a really simple tool that will help you decide all at once both what to eat and how much to eat. Do note, insulin resistance is a common occurrence in PCOS, prediabetes, type 2 diabetes, and in some cases of obesity too. And the method I'm about to explain can be used for either of these conditions. So this is a modified version of the MyPlate graphic developed by the US FDA, and we'll be using this plate method. This plate basically just shows you what your actual plate should look like at all or most mealtimes. Half your plate should be filled with non-starchy vegetables. That's right, half your plate. And you need to make sure that these are non-starchy veggies. But what are non-starchy veggies? These are basically all your green leafy vegetables, vegetables like cauliflower, tomatoes, and veggies that we commonly eat as sabzis, like bhindi. And these vegetables can be eaten as a salad, a stir fry, a soup, a juice, or even just as sabzi, depending on your preference. You can pick one or a combination of these, but these should make up half your plate. Once you've filled half your plate with vegetables, 1/4 of it should be filled with a food rich in protein. Your best sources for this are meat, poultry, eggs, dairy products like milk, dahi and paneer, and beans, pulses and soybean. Now, if you are vegetarian, do note we tend to underserve ourselves this portion of the plate. So it's important that you get a whole variety of these foods throughout the day. And lastly, only the remaining 1/4 portion of your plate should be filled with foods like millets, like jowar and bajra, or grains like wheat and rice, or starchy vegetables like corn and potatoes, or fruits like banana and mangoes. If you do want to include fruits at mealtime, they occupy this portion of the plate. And we very, very often overdo this portion of the plate. Think about when you're portioning your plate. Are you doing twice the amount of sabzi as compared to roti or rice? If you are, good job. If not, make this small change and it will already go a long way towards helping your insulin resistance and PCOS. Now, if you're worried that you're going to stay hungry because you're decreasing the quantity of the roti or rice, do remember you're also increasing the quantity of the other foods. I promise you, you won't stay hungry. Your veggies and your protein will keep you really, really full. Also note, I haven't used any actual numbers anywhere, only ratios. This is because it's really hard to comment on how much food you should eat because all of us have such varying lifestyles and such different needs. However much or little you eat, make sure that you're plating it in this manner. Half plate non-starchy vegetables, 1/4 plate protein, and 1/4 plate grain or starchy vegetable. Even if you're taking more than one helping of food, try and make sure as much as possible that you're maintaining these proportions. So this is a pretty standard guideline for eating with insulin resistance, but even if you don't have any underlying health condition, this is a really nice way to make sure that you're getting a whole variety of all the nutrients that you need in a day to maintain good health. So by all means, you can go ahead and use this style of eating too. That being said, I did mention that there are some nutrients that girls with PCOS can concentrate on. So let's look at these next. Number one, fiber. Now, while this is important for everyone, it's really important for girls who have PCOS. Remember how I said if you have insulin resistance, there are chances it can increase your cholesterol? Well, making sure that you're getting adequate fiber in your diet can really help keep those cholesterol levels in check. So when you're plating your plate, make sure that at least half your grains that you eat in the whole day are whole grains. Make sure you're getting your non-starchy vegetables. And in the protein group, your beans and pulses are a really good source of fiber too. Also remember, fiber helps you poop. And if you do have PCOS, there is some component of hormonal imbalance in your body. And these excess hormones that cause your uncomfortable symptoms, especially around your periods, get excreted when you poop. Number two, antioxidants, especially omega-3 fats and vitamin E. Because PCOS can cause chronic low-grade inflammation, which is really bad for the general health of the body, but especially of the heart, making sure that you're getting enough omega-3 fats from your food can really help curb inflammation. These are most commonly found in fish, so try and get in a good helping of fatty fish at least twice a week. If you're vegetarian, you can look to your flax seeds and walnuts for some omega-3 fats. Speaking of seeds, these are also a fabulous source of the antioxidant vitamin E, and you can try seed cycling, and I've linked a video in the description about how you can do this. Number three, zinc. This is a nutrient which in particular can help reduce hyperandrogenism or high levels of male hormone in women, which can worsen insulin resistance. Zinc is also really important for the creation, the storage, and the body's proper use of insulin. So you definitely want to make sure that you're getting enough of this nutrient in. A great source of zinc are oysters, but if you don't have access to oysters, look at your meat and poultry. And for the vegetarians, we have your beans, nuts, seeds, whole grains, and dairy. So again, eating a varied diet in accordance to the portions explained in the meal plate kind of ensures that you're getting in all these nutrients that you need. So have we covered everything? What about fat? A special note about fat. You will notice that there is no designated portion in this plate for fat, even though it is a super important nutrient. You absolutely do need fat in your diet. It majorly helps curb inflammation, and it's the basic raw material that makes up the very hormones that are dysregulated when you have PCOS. Normally though, some forms of fat are usually found in food, and we normally cook using some form of fat like oil, ghee or butter. So you don't really need to make a special place for it on your plate. That being said, nuts, seeds and dairy have some great sources of fat as well as other nutrients in them, and you can definitely incorporate these into your snacks to make for both a satisfying and nutritious snack. So to summarize, half plate non-starchy veggies, 1/4 plate protein, 1/4 plate grain or starchy vegetables, and make sure that most of your grains are whole grains and that you're eating most of your fruits and vegetables whole, which means with the skin intact, which will ensure that you're getting all these other nutrients that you need to help manage your PCOS smoothly. Lastly, if all of this is seeming too overwhelming for you, but you feel like you still need help, please do reach out to me either over email, over Instagram, or in the comments below, and I can help clear your doubts. That's all for today. I hope you enjoyed this video and found it helpful. If you did, please like, share, and subscribe to my channel and help it with others who may also find it helpful. Do remember, September is PCOS Awareness Month, so I'll be covering all things PCOS. It is also National Nutrition Month, so if you have any generic burning nutrition question, please ask me and I'd love to have it answered for you. I hope to see you very soon. Until then, take care and keep shining.